friends, this is Yogesh Popat and today we are here with the topic terminologies for spherical surfaces, which is related to optics. So if you see here, I have just considered the two spherical mirrors which are categorized as concave mirror and convex mirror. If you consider this sphere to be the imaginary sphere, and if I cut out this portion separately, so it will look like this. Now in this, if I polish the bulged out part, this is called the bulged out part and this is called the caved part. Okay, so if it is like this, this is called the caved part and this is called the bulged out part. So if this caved part is reflecting and the bulged out part is polished, then that type of mirror will be termed as concave mirror. If the bulged out part is reflecting and the caved part is polished, then this type of mirror will be termed as convex mirror. So in this, the reflecting part is the caved part, in this the reflecting part is the bulged out part. Now for these mirrors, we are going to discuss about the different terminologies that we have written in the right hand side. These mirrors are considered to be a part of hollow imaginary sphere. Okay, so the first terminology that is written over here is pole. Now what is pole? If we consider this part to be a mirror, so pole is basically, it is the midpoint of the mirror. The midpoint of the mirror is called pole. Second point, if we see the center of curvature. Now what is center of curvature? We have considered this mirror, spherical mirror, which may be of two types, concave and convex, is considered to be a part of an imaginary sphere. So the center of this imaginary sphere, from which the mirror is considered to be a part of, will be termed as center of curvature. Okay, so what is pole? It is the midpoint of the mirror. What is center of curvature? It is the center of the imaginary hollow sphere from which the mirror is constructed, or of which the mirror is considered to be a part of. Third point is radius of curvature. Now what is the radius of curvature? A radius of curvature is the radius of the imaginary sphere. You can take it like this. The radius of the imaginary sphere of which the mirror is considered to be a part of. Okay, so this is the hollow sphere, imaginary sphere from which these two mirrors are constructed. The center of this hollow sphere will be termed as the center of curvature. The radius of this mirror will be termed as the radius of curvature. Okay, you may draw it here also, from C to P also this will be radius of curvature. So this will also be R. Okay, next point is focus and focal length. Now to indicate focus and focal length, I need to draw a different diagram. So I will just change this diagram to indicate focus and focal length. Now what is focus here? Suppose if you take the concave mirror to be here. In this concave mirror, we have understood that the caved part is reflecting, due to which this will have a converging property. How it will have a converging property? Let us see. The midpoint of the mirror, I told you that it will be pole, and the line joining the center of curvature and pole is termed as principal axis. This line, this imaginary line, will be termed as principal axis. Now if the incident rays are parallel to the principal axis, so let us take two incident rays parallel to the principal axis. You can take more also if you want. So after reflection through this caved part from a concave mirror, It converges to a common point. So this point of meeting on the principal axis is termed as focus. Focus means is to concentrate, to converge. So this point on the principal axis where all the incident rays converges is called focus, and the distance between focus and pole is termed as focal length. So this point is called focus, and the separation or the distance between focus and pole is termed as focal length. So this will be termed as focal length. Okay, so we had a discussion on pole, we had a discussion on center of curvature, we had a discussion on radius of curvature. Radius of curvature will be from C to T. This will be radius of curvature. Principal axis, I have told you that the line joining, you may define it, the principal axis as the line joining center of curvature, focus and pole, can also be referred as principal axis. Now what is aperture here? If I mark it as point M1 and this end to be M2, so this effective length of the mirror is termed as aperture. Okay. Now this is the ray diagram of the focus for concave mirror, where the rays are actually meeting at a common point which is called focus. So this will be termed as a real focus. But if you draw it for convex mirror, what will happen? If I draw it for convex mirror, what will happen? So for convex mirror, the caved part is to be polished and the bulged out part will be reflecting. Now here the bulged out part is reflecting due to which it has a diverging property. Concave mirror has a converging property because the caved part is reflecting. Convex mirror has a diverging property because the bulged out part is reflecting. So if I draw here a principal axis, here the spherical surface will be at this side, you can see here. For concave mirror, if you draw, this side will be considered as the part of hollow sphere, but in convex mirror, this will form the hollow mirror, the hollow sphere like this. Okay, so focus and center of curvature will lie at the right hand side of the convex mirror. How? Suppose again two rays are parallel to the principal axis, but this convex mirror has a diverging property, so these rays will diverge. The reflected rays will diverge. The reflected rays will diverge. Now here you can see these two reflected rays are diverging. That means definitely they are not going to meet at the left hand side. So what we have to do, we have to extend these reflected rays behind the mirror like we did for plane mirror. So if I extend this reflected ray 1 and reflected ray 2 behind the mirror, so approximately it will meet at this common point. So this will be termed as focus, and since here the rays appears to meet at focus, so this will be termed as a virtual focus. So for convex mirror, generally the focus will be considered as a virtual focus because it is behind the mirror. For concave mirror, as you have seen, it is in front of the reflecting surface where the rays are actually meeting, so that will be termed as real focus. And here this will be the center of curvature. Again, this will be the radius of curvature, the distance between pole and focus, and the separation between, you have to extend it here, and the separation between pole and focus will be termed as focal length. Okay, so this is all about the terminologies. Pole is the midpoint of the mirror. Center of curvature is the center of the imaginary sphere from which the mirror is constructed. Radius of curvature is the radius of the imaginary hollow sphere from which the mirror is constructed. Focus and focal length. Focus is the point where all the reflected rays converges or appears to converge on the principal axis. That will be termed as focus. And the separation between focus and pole will be termed as focal length. Principal axis is the imaginary line joining the center of curvature, focus and pole. And upper aperture is the effective length of the mirror, that is from this part to this part. Okay. See you in the next class. We'll have a discussion on the ray diagram for concave mirror in the next class. Thank you so much.